Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernard from BTN HD, and today is all about installing WSUS within the Windows Server 2019. So let's get started. So on my desktop, I'm going to right click on the start menu, go to run, type in WinVER, and hit OK. And I'm doing everything within a Server 2019 version 1809 build 17763. Okay. So first things first, we need to open up our server manager. So click on start and locate server manager. And on the upper right side of the server manager console, you want to click on manage, click on add roles and features. You're going to get the nice little add roles and features wizard. Click next here, next again. From here, you want to go all the way down, scroll down to the point that you see Windows Server Update Services and give it a check mark. When you get a check mark, you're going to get additional things that is required for the WSUS to be installed onto your server. So just click on add features. And then click next here. From here, you can skip it. Click next, next again. And for the roles, by default, you're going to get the Windows database and the WSUS services. Now, you don't need to use the WID connectivity. If you have a SQL server, you can do it that way. I'm gonna leave everything as the default and click on next. Now, for the path, I'm gonna open up my Windows Explorer. And I'm going to go inside my C drive. It's not best practice to drop it inside the C drive, but this is the only thing that I have on this machine. So within here, I'm going to create a new folder, right click in it, go to new, go to folder, and name it updates. I'm going to open up updates, and I'm going to basically copy the path, and then go back inside the wizard and paste the path inside that text box, and then click on next. Next here, leave all the web services as the default. You don't need to change it. Click next here. And I'm going to check restart the destination server automatically if it's required. Definitely click yes here and then install. And it's really fast. It takes between, I would say, 2 or 3 minutes. Once it's done, you're going to get a nice little hyperlink that says launch post installation task. If you click on it, it's going to start saying, please wait while your server is being configured. You know, walk away, go grab lunch, go get a cup of coffee. Eventually, when you come back, it's going to say configuration successfully completed. And you're somewhat done. Click close. And once you click close, what you want to do is basically go to start. And within start, go inside Windows Administrative Tools and go all the way to the bottom to the point that you see the Windows Server Update Services app. Click on it, you're going to get the user account control, just click on yes, and you're going to get the WSUS wizard. From here, read what you need, click next. If you want to basically join the Microsoft Update program, that's up to you. By default, it's checked. I like to uncheck it, and then click next. I'm definitely gonna synchronize from the Microsoft Update, so click next here. I don't have a proxy within my, you know, within my network, so I'm gonna click next here. And then click start connecting. This process does take some time. And once everything is completed, you should have the next button highlighted. And it allows you to basically click next to continue. Pick your language. And once you pick your language, click on next. And this is where you basically tell your WSUS what you want within this Windows Server, server, what's to be pulled down locally to your machine. So I like to just basically uncheck Windows and just pick what I want. Because if you don't uncheck Windows, the root of Windows, you're gonna get all that stuff pushed down to your server. You don't really want that. So unchecking Windows, and then picking what operating system that you want. Like for me, I did Windows 10, and that's it, click next. Pick what classifications you want. I left everything as a default. I do want the critical updates, the definition updates, the security updates, and upgrades. It's really up to you what you want. Again, it's your environment, your network, so pick what you want. Click next here. From here, you are able to synchronize manually or synchronize automatically on a specific time. This is up to you, okay? Once you do what you want, you click on next, and then uncheck begin initial synchronization, and then click next here, and then hit finish. Once you hit finish, your update services console opens up. And if you go inside synchronization, you're going to see that it's running. It's going to start pulling down all those Windows updates from the Windows Server online. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video of how to install WSUS within Server 2019. Pretty simple. Hopefully you guys enjoy. Leave comments right below. Don't forget about hitting that like button. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.